So let's be crazy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella vez, le busco todo. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino can.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
These cards to a higher gem color just by playing games. Many evolution cards have already been released this year, and you can earn even more by playing Domination, where you take on 99 teams with some top tier prizes, if you can beat them all. Challenges return with the addition of new Spotlight Challenges. These sets have their own special collections based around the careers of spectators.
The tallest building in the state of Indiana, the Chase Tower, rising high above our locations today at Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Happy New Year's Eve. Thank you for joining us here on 2K Sports for the NBA. We're all dressed up and ready to go. And tonight, it'll be the Indiana Pacers going up against the Philadelphia 76ers. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and two Hall of Famers. Doris Burke here at the table, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. D.A., take it away.
Well, Ben Simmons was the top-rated player in high school and in college. But a fractured bone in his foot cost him his first NBA season. He said, "A lot of people forgot about me. You have to build yourself up again. And for me, I wanted to prove myself again." Kevin, we all agree, he's done just that.
He sure has. First NBA All-Star ever out of Australia. Thanks, David. And a quick look here at some of the numbers for Brogdon.
And he's not passing the ball as well this month. If you look at his numbers from earlier in the season, he's not seeing the court as well. It may be a little too focused on creating his own shot than orchestrating for the guys around him.
Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. The tall lineup out there for the 76ers. Simmons, Richardson, Harris, Horford, and Embiid. And for Indiana, Sabonis and Turner up front. Brogdon out there with Jeremy Lamb. And it's Warren in at the three, the small forward. Well, around this time of year, lots of national broadcasted games, Doris. Does that impact the players, you think, in any way?
I certainly think the guys are aware of the nights they're on national television. Some guys relish, Kev, as you know, the opportunity to play on the big stage. So for the regular season, those nights where you know the entire country is watching, that's a big deal.
Here's Lamb. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
Yeah, there's no quitting this guy. He just gives you great effort, and he continues to give you great production.
Passes it to Harris. There's the double team with Lamb. And Horford wide open. He shoots. No good on the three. Looking at the last game for the Indiana Pacers, it was a loss to the Pelicans. Al Horford with the rebound. Simmons against Brogdon. Stolen by Brogdon. Outside, Lamb. Out of bounds, Philadelphia takes possession.
76ers ball.
And here's Embiid. He'll bring it up for Philadelphia. Simmons passes to Embiid. And there's the call on Malcolm Brogdon. That's his first foul.
Ref's calling it close already as he picks up a quick early foul.
We're about 1 minute into the first. Pass to Harris. Kicks it out to Richardson. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
Here's Brogdon. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
At the end of the day, though, it's 2 points. Don't hang your heads. Let's get refocused and play with more patience.
And Philadelphia has possession following the score by Indiana. And Simmons kicks to Richardson. It's hauled in by Warren.
All alone from mid-range. They know he won't miss many of those.
Here's Turner, and the Pacers tack on two more.
Talk about hitting the ground running. 4-for-5 to start.
Philadelphia's gone 1-for-2 from long range in the first quarter. Ogden against Simmons. Richardson, the basket good off the assist from Simmons. Richardson's got 5 points so far.
And passes like that demonstrate the winning mindset Simmons has. A guy that wants to get his team involved.
And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. The pass to Harris. No good on that one. And Indiana will come the other way. And Brogdon, here we go. It's good for his second make. He's made 2 of 3 so far.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Richardson against Lamb. And Brogdon comes over to help. Harris passes to Horford. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good.
Well, that's just about sheer effort from Al Horford. The defense made their presence felt, but Horford utilizes his length.
Here's the break. Lots of room. They get the rebound. And the shot goes in from Embiid.
And the D getting outworked there on the putback. Can't let that happen.
Greg, you have got to put a body on somebody. Talk about it ad nauseum, but you've got to be disciplined with the box outs. Well, that's a case where your teammates are showing trust in you, and he comes through with flying colors.
Richardson left side. Harris outside. Lock at 6, and the foul on Miles Turner. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul.
Embiid wide open. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. Embiid's got his second bucket of the game to go.
You know, people refer to Al Horford being the hub for this team. Defensively, he's always in the right position and such a good playmaker for a big man.
Here's Simmons after Malcolm Brogdon's bucket. Harris looking it over. Back to Simmons. And it's sent back by Turner.
How about Turner's ability to anticipate when the shooter's going to release? Couldn't be better at timing his rejections.
And it's no coincidence teammates often have the best seasons of their careers, Doris, playing alongside Al Horford.
I think, Kevin, that has everything to do with his passing ability, but also his willingness to be an incredible screener. This guy walls off defenders as long as possible, maybe even flirting with a moving screen. All I know is guys get wide open looks off of Al Horford's screening ability.
No good from Lamb.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
And a dunk by Horford.
One thing you can't afford is to allow Al Horford to get to this spot. It's over if you do.
Here's Brogdon. Oh, offensive interference.
The basket counts. That'll be goaltending.
The 76ers trail by four. Richardson outside. And Brogdon comes over to help. And a dunk by Horford.
And this game already taking shape as an offensive battle.
Well, the fans love it. Coaches may not like the lack of defense, but boy, the rules promote scoring, no doubt.
And you know, you can't impact a shot that close any better than he did on that possession.
Boy, whether he blocks it or simply alters it, the result is pretty much the same.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Philadelphia. They've got an 8-0 run. No good from Simmons. So it's the Pacers now, defeated by the Pelicans in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
Live by the three, die by the three. If you're perimeter dependent, you don't really know game to game how it's going to go.
But Greg, I think when you shoot as poorly as they did from deep in that basketball game, it's not going to go your way very often. The three ball, too critical in today's NBA.
And how about that instant response? Don't try to throw down on his team. It just gets them fired up.
And that's the result. They launch an assault on the basket. So the Pacers call timeout, their first of the game. Well, sometimes what was once considered a negative becomes a positive. For example, tweeners are now looked at as very valuable assets, very versatile assets.
Yeah, Kev, no doubt. That, like, think about how much the game has changed for players like Draymond Green, who was so integral to the success of the Golden State Warriors. Here was a young guy who was considered at one point coming out of college with a power forward and center spot, too small to play the position. But as the NBA has downsized, as it's gotten smaller and faster, Draymond Green can be as important as any other player on a roster.
And some changes here for the Pacers. Doug McDermott, he's checked in for Sabonis. Justin Holliday comes in for Jeremy Lamb. And it's TJ McConnell in for Malcolm Brogdon. Now, here's McConnell. And right now, he's averaging about 7 points a game.
And you see the ability to rise and fire from mid-range, even against that length.
Well, I'll tell you, I love that he's not afraid to take on the size mismatch there, Greg. Doesn't matter. Just make shots.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
First personal foul.
And when he gets ahead of steam, you almost feel sorry for defenders. Ben Simmons, a combination of size, speed, and ball handling that can at times be unstoppable.
And they now lead as the free throw drops for him. And with his passing and driving ability, Greg, Simmons is like combining a power running back in football with a pinpoint passing quarterback.
With the
not much he can't do.
Kevin, a football metaphor is appropriate. Simmons grew up playing Australian rules football, and the physicality and quick thinking of that sport really reflected in his style of play.
Harris misses.
Well, they are daring him to miss, and he obliges.
Here's Warren, and again, it's Indiana converting.
Well, this guy loves to take advantage of mid-range shots. T.J. Warren in his comfort zone there.
Embiid, the pass to Richardson. For three, Pacers with the rebound. Their last meeting was in Philadelphia, where they were unable to fight off the 76ers.
Very tough loss than last time they played. I mean, in the end, the amount of trips to the line they gave up did them in.
Now, here's Richardson. After T.J. Warren's miss, Embiid's shot is good.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Here's McConnell. Rebound by Joel Embiid. Embiid's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Here's Richardson, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Richardson's got seven.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Here's McConnell in the hoop for his third make from the field. He's 3-for-4 thus far in the contest. And Simmons has got the ball here for the 76ers. They trail by one. Yep, it counts. 9 points in the game so far.
Well, I absolutely love the way this guy has controlled the pace tonight. They've been able to play the style they want.
Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
76ers.
In a moment here to check out the numbers for Turner. Averaging 12 points, just over 2 blocks, and 5 rebounds. And not many players possess his kind of ability to protect the rim. I mean, you look at the block total, pretty remarkable.
Well, I love it. Drivers think they see a crease to the lane and go for it. And eventually, he shuts the door.
And Simmons kicks to Harris. The basket good off the assist from Simmons.
Well, the defense daring him to shoot, and he makes them pay for their disrespect.
Pacers trail by 4. From 15 feet away, and the Pacers tack on 2 more. Philadelphia has gone 2-for-5 from three-point land here in the first quarter. Pass to Horford on the wing. Harris. Another three for Philadelphia.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Nice shot by McDermott.
Well, this is one aspect you'd like to see more of from T.J. Warren. We know he's a great scorer. Pretty dime there.
Harris against Holiday. Harris passes to Embiid. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. T.J. Warren picks one up.
That's his first personal foul. At the line.
Well, what's not to like about Joel Embiid? A physical specimen at over 7 feet tall. All the skill in the world and a personality made for stardom.
First free throw is good. You talk about Embiid's personality, whether it's on the court or through social media. Greg, he's not shy speaking his mind.
One of the best trash talkers in the league. He doesn't hold back, but it's never personal. He's embracing the spirit of competition.
And the 76ers making a change here. Mike Scott's checked in for Horford. Ennis comes in for Tobias Harris. Barkmaz, he's jacked in for Josh Richardson. And Raul Neto subbed in for Simmons. Holiday gets the bucket. The 76ers leading by 3. Here's Neto. Stolen by Holiday. And here we go. Holiday heading to the hoop. It's good.
And that's such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
Philadelphia's gone 3-for-6, 50% from deep so far tonight. Neto, the pass to Ennis. Sweet little floater. And the 76ers lead by 3.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
And it's blocked by Scott. It's Korkmaz in the corner. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
A stupendous finish in traffic.
Holiday's
got six.
A little artistry in the painted area, converting against the size.
Some guys just relish the challenge. Find a way, and he does.
Here's Scott, and they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
That right there is as good a screen as you will see, and no one rotates defensively to pick up the open man.
76ers have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3-for-3.
And taking a look at their free throw statistics on the season, right around 74%.
And the 76ers making a change here. O'Quinn's checked in. A free throw off from Scott. And coming into this season, questions about whether the Sixers could retain their star players. No, Greg, they shuffled the decks, but they still have great talent.
Swapping in Al Horford for Jimmy Butler, Josh Richardson for J.J. Redick. The Sixers still in the mix to come out of the East. And I like how he draws the attention on the inside and then the nice little kick out in rhythm for the jumper.
Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
And this is like another case of Murphy's Law right now. And it's been their own doing, really, just like we saw there.
And so it's Neto with the ball. He'll bring it up for the 76ers. They're leading by 8. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of Miami.
Yeah, nowhere near at their best throughout the course of that game. A scrappy performance, but in the end, just not enough.
You know, their energy kicked in down the stretch, but too many mistakes overall. Just was not their night. Looked like some confusion defensively that time. Left him wide open for a nice look on the jumper.
Ennis in the corner from the arc. That one, no good. Oh, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. 76ers lead by 8. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment. Joel Embiid talks about making a quick transition to the United States.
Not knowing English, obviously at the beginning, it was a little bit hard to like express myself. Obviously, I can speak English perfectly now, so that's a plus, and I'm just being myself.
And that unique sense of humor, Greg, is a specialty of Embiid.
He's a fun-loving guy who's become a must-follow on social media. And the transition he's made has been remarkable.
And we're getting back to the action in our New Year's Eve broadcast. And guys, what's your take so far in Philadelphia?
Just stretching out the floor that first. They had the defense scrambling.
And that was obviously the plan coming in. Now the big question, can they maintain that efficiency from range as the game goes along?
Taking a look at the 76ers. Mike's got up there with Ennis. Then there's Kyle O'Quinn. And it's Neto in at the point guard position. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Kevin, Josh Richardson has made himself into one of the top defensive wings in the league. Richardson says there's a certain competitiveness that comes with being a good defender. The defensive end takes will, and I have a lot of it. Kevin, J. Rich is self-described as super competitive, and that edge is what drives him.
It sure is. That's what it takes. Thank you, David.
And after nailing a three-pointer in the first quarter, he has yet to connect here in the second.
The shot by Holiday, no good. And Justin Holiday picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Miami's checked in for Justin Holiday.
Jeremy Lamb.
The 76ers leading by six. Neto surveying the floor. He feeds it to Scott. It's blocked. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession. He sees his ball. Malcolm Brogdon's checked in for the Pacers.
Malcolm Brogdon!
Second quarter of action, about a minute and a half played. Drains James it from beyond Ennis. The arc. Ennis has got 10.
Boy, the big man, Kyle O'Quinn, showing pretty touch on the pass.
Now here is Holiday. Defense is right there. Score the bucket. He's made five so far, shooting a very clean 5 of 7. The 76ers have gone 2 of 6 from the field in the second quarter so far. Passes to Neto. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Scott. It's good. The assist that time for Menace. 5 points in the game.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. 3 of their last 5 baskets are from three-point range.
I'll tell you, most of the time, this guy's going to finish that. But that was tremendous defense that prohibits him from completing the play.
And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Here's Neto. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Now Ennis. O'Quinn trying to free himself up. Another shot. And that one's good. Quirkmaz. And the 76ers James lead by 10. Pacers have gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. Here's Holiday. Here's Leaf. Nice work on the board. Staying off with the basket. Leafs got his second basket of the game.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
Brogdon outside. Takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely.
Want easy looks? Don't allow the defense to set up.
What a beautiful fast break opportunity, and the finish pretty good.
Here's Korkmaz. He has 6. Ball's back loose. And another turnover here by Philadelphia. And now a chance to see what's coming up for Philadelphia. On Friday, they'll be playing against James Harden and the Houston Rockets. And then on Monday, they'll be facing Steven Adams and the Oklahoma City Thunder.
And for their matchup with the Celtics, there aren't many other meetings that are as evenly matched as this one. Both teams can give and take punches, and this one, I think, is going to come down to the wire. Gives the team such a great element, having a one guard who can get to the 10.
Certainly something every team wants to have.
Well, you love it, Kevin. Fearless, aggressive, leaving no doubt whatsoever. All by himself, trying to step up. He's got to be frustrated with the miss.
And the foul called on Korkmaz. That is his first foul of the game. The Pacers making a switch here. Sabonis is checked in. So it's the Pacers now. He's now 1 for 2 with that bucket.
We are talking about 6'11", 240 pounds of nothing but big-time athlete. Domantas Sabonis doing work.
And so it's Neto with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers.
Domantas Sabonis enters the league as the 11th pick in 2016. That first season, I don't think people understood how good he could be. His improvement, his ability as a promising big man in this league, unquestioned at this point.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball. And you look at the development for Sabonis, what stands out?
Well, I think he's made strides across the board, Kevin. And for me, this is as fundamentally sound a big man as you'll find in the league. He's a triple threat on the offensive end. He is super smart on the defensive end and quite versatile. He can guard both front court positions.
Turner's checked in for Indiana. Warren comes in for Leaf. Free throw drops for Lamb. Doris, you graduated as your college's all-time assist leader. Talk about some of the key traits of a great playmaker.
I think historically speaking, when we think about great lead guards, Kevin, we talk about unselfishness, vision, patience. Who are the players that make their teammates better? Though probably the one underrated aspect of a point guard to me, Kevin, is communication. Are you constantly looking for opportunities to communicate to your teammates, make them feel good about themselves, give them confidence? That, to me, is probably the most underrated aspect of it.
And Doris, when you played, you took such great pride in each and every one of those things.
I did. I love trying to make my teammates better. It feels great to make somebody feel good.
No shortage of drama here early on.
Yeah, 8 lead changes already. Huge number this early.
Kicks it out to Richardson. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got 3 assists in the game. Here's McConnell. Second shot opportunity. Shot's good by Turner.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
Simmons passes to Horford. Richardson gets a wide open look. They get it back. And another shot. Oh, Quinn can't hit. Indiana leading. And it's Turner off the drive. 6 for 6. He's yet to miss from the field.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Philadelphia has gone 6 of 14 with the 3 ball tonight. Just a little over 40%. No one near him. The shot's good from O'Quinn. O'Quinn's got his first 2 points.
Well, you've got to be able to pick your spots if you're not the primary option. And Kyle O'Quinn on the catch and shoot, nice.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam. Using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there, sure. And here is Simmons. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Miami. Richardson for 3. It's rebounded by Indiana. Turner's got his 4th rebound in this one. Here's Warren. That one off the back iron and out. The 76ers trail by 3. Here's Simmons. The rebound by Turner. Warren, the pass to Brogdon. Fires the 3. Sabonis. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for 1 more at the line.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim. And you look at per minute production, you can make a strong case that Domantas Sabonis at times has been underutilized. With consistent minutes, he can give you an efficient 20-10 every night.
Embiid, he's checked in for Kyle O'Quinn. And Sabonis having to spend some time at the power forward spot in today's game, Greg. He's pretty big for that position.
I mean, 6'11", 240. He's gotten leaner, done some yoga, worked on strengthening those hips, looking to stay mobile. And that ought to serve him whichever position he plays.
The shot's good. 16 points for Malcolm Brogdon.
I tell you, he's making everything he looks at tonight. He should be their number one option on every possession.
Richardson outside. Buries the long-range jumper. Richardson's got 5 points in the quarter.
And how about the terrific use of the crossover there to just throw the defender off balance?
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. Well, maybe not the most well-known player in the league, but Josh Richardson has been a big source of offense, and Brady's done it for a while now.
A bit of a specialist, but Richardson has no problem putting up and making threes.
Malcolm Brogdon.
Yeah, and checking out some stats here for Ben Simmons. He's been fantastic over the last 10 games or so, averaging 15 points a game, 9 assists, and 7 rebounds. And with his great passing, he's been a catalyst for their offense, often seeing plays even before they materialize.
There's no doubt about that. Great anticipation, excellent peripheral vision. His talents are really shining through.
Personal foul.
And here are the Pacers now. It's a three-point game.
And after that solid opening quarter, you can see now he is definitely starting to cool off.
Down low, here's Embiid, and Embiid throws it down.
Well, known for being a terrific passer, he shows you right there. Case in point.
The shot by McConnell, no good.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
That boy, to have someone back there who can erase your mistakes, what a big-time asset defensively.
Here's Sumner, and two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the content. Nora, such an honor to be on this with you, and you were the first female to become a full-time NBA analyst, breaking new ground. You've accomplished so much in your life, personally, professionally. What would you tell young women who are graduating college, looking to get ahead in their career in what you've chosen?
Well, first and foremost, I've been very lucky, Kevin. The game of basketball has been a part of my life since I was 7. It's been a driving force. I love it. I would just tell young women, times are changing. Dream big. There's nothing that's impossible. And I'm so thankful to the NBA players and coaches who have just wrapped their arms around me from the time I entered this business. So kudos to those players who are part of the change, no question.
And hard work. I have seen you work. I have seen you prepare. No one prepares more. No one works harder than you.
Thanks, Kev.
Both good from the line that time. Now, here's Richardson. He's got 12. Here's Simmons. Great pass to set up the lay-in. Simmons got 11 points.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Here's Sabonis. That's good, and he's now 3-for-4 from the field.
Well, after a less-than-stellar start in the first quarter, you like to see that shot go down.
76ers trailing. Richardson outside, and they're running. Drops in the breakaway layup.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both. Nicely done.
And here's Simmons. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. And Philadelphia with another turnover here.
Indiana ball.
And let's take this chance to break out the real stats, real scores from the real NBA and the list of the league's leading teams in steals. The 76ers third.
You can't get careless with the basketball against this group. I mean, they'll pick your pocket, and no surprise to see them in the upper echelon as far as steals. A little ambitious on that possession, trying to hit a shot in the face of that defensive pressure.
Good, and Harris gets the assist. And it's 13 points for Ben Simmons.
Yeah, the quickness, the size, and the speed of Simmons, really breathtaking, especially when he's dribbling the rock.
And McConnell gets it to go. The 76ers trail by 3. Pass to Embiid. Lucky 7 drops in. He's perfect from the floor. 7-for-7.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Sumner's shot is off. Philadelphia has gotten the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it, 9 times they've missed. And a dunk by Horford.
Just focusing on the task at hand, that's all you can do.
Boy, the tide is running one way and then shifts back in the other direction. I've lost count of how many lead changes we've had here tonight.
Well, guys, this first half has been about as tightly contested as you could hope for.
There have been a lot of lead changes.
Now, here's Horford. 10 points for him. And, oh, boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2. It's going to be on Miles Turner. The 76ers shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game.
Richardson at the line for 2.
That's good from Richardson.
And this Pacers franchise, 6 ABA championships, but none so far in the NBA.
Well, Greg, they haven't been there very much, right? Their only finals trip came back in 2000. It took a Lakers squad led by Shaq and Kobe to 6 games. But ever since, they've been chomping at the bit to try to get back.
And that one goes in, 2 from the line that time.
There is so much to love about this Pacers team. Each guy, I feel like, is committed to having their teammates back. Go back to when Oladipo went out last year. A variety of different guys step up. They almost captured the 4 seed. Incredible.
Here's Simmons, following the score by Indiana.
Simmons. Yeah, and when Simmons is driving inside, he's going to sky up for the flush, getting to the basket in no time.
Good on the bucket. Holiday's got 14 points.
And he is really in a zone right now, playing and scoring with confidence.
One item that stood out, their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking. And more importantly, it makes it really hard to defend.
Shots good by Simmons.
A hard worker who really ferociously strives to improve. Simmons tonight has been unstoppable at the offensive end. And not allowing the shooter even an inch of breathing room on that one.
Right. He stays connected and great timing on the contest. Well, the pass to set up that bucket was terrific. Fired it right up the court. Didn't allow the defense to react in time. Nice.
And so here is Philadelphia. They've led by as much as 10. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Knocks it loose, and it goes out of bounds. That one's off Holiday.
Philadelphia ball.
Find some changes here for the 76ers. Mike Scott comes in for Al Horford, and it's Ennis in for Josh Richardson. We've got 22 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Embiid kicks to Harris. Pocket 4. Fires from the wing. That's good on the jump shot. Harris has got 4 points in the quarter. Holiday goes in. And the rejection by Embiid. Up in time. He's off on that one. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Philadelphia ahead, up 3. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Indianapolis.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Greetings to each and every one of you watching at this very moment. I'm Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is here. Shaq is here. One half is behind us. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Ben Simmons had it going on in the first quarter. He ended up with 17 points, 2 rebounds, and 8 assists. And from what we saw so far from the Sixers, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Well, the 3-point shooting was the key thus far. When you're knocking down those shots from the perimeter, it really spreads the floor. You demand respect from the defense. We'll see if they can keep it flowing in the second half.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Indiana?
Aggressive. I called them up earlier. I like it. They're taking it hard to the rack, dictating the pace, setting the physical tone. You're not going to get that by launching threes all night. Everybody knows that.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See you, everybody, with Kevin Harlan.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game it's been so far. What a game we're seeing from Simmons.
Man, he's been running wild on him through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far, unstoppable.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. Philadelphia leading by 3. Sabonis and Turner up front. Jeremy Lamb out there with Brogdon, and it's Warren in at the three spot. So that's the group out there for Indiana. Simmons. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And this summer, a five-year, $170 million max contract to Ben Simmons. The Sixers didn't want to give him any cause to look elsewhere. A great talent, but the hope with that kind of money is that he'll develop that jump shot.
That's good from Simmons.
The 2018 Rookie of the Year. Simmons' NBA career got off to a great start, and he's only continued to improve.
And Simmons drops them both. Pacers trail by five. Here's Lamb. It's good, only a few seconds into the shot clock. Lamb's got nine.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
And Simmons kicks to Richardson. 76ers moving the ball around. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. And that's 17 points for Josh Richardson.
You can see he just has a great overall feel for this game. Excellent job tonight.
And that's been his role pretty much from the opening tip. Get the ball to guys where they can score it.
Now, here's Sabonis. Over Horford. Not as good in the 76ers. Lead is cut down to just 4 points in the bucket from Sabonis.
This is a real strength of Domantas Sabonis' game. He has such nice, soft touch.
Embiid kicks to Richardson. Back to Embiid. Shoots over Turner. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. It's going to go on Sabonis. And after he missed the first two seasons of his career, Greg, with a broken bone in his foot, would injuries be your main concern for Joel Embiid?
No doubt about it. As long as he's healthy, he's an all-league performer. Still, seven-footers carry a lot of weight in our league. He wants to prove he can play big minutes. They just got to make sure they protect him.
And that one misses. And he's good on the second. Pacers trail by five. Here's Turner, and again it's Indiana.
Wow, what a start to this half. 3 for 3, dictating the pace on the offensive end. They're rolling early.
Philadelphia shooting an incredible 64% from the field in this game. Embiid, no good. Embiid with the steal. To the middle. Good, and Harris gets the assist. Harris has got his fifth assist in this one.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
And that one's good, Brogdon. And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now. Simmons with it. 19 points in the game. Horford the pass to Richardson. Kicks it to Embiid. Horford with it. Six on the shot clock. For the three. And that's out of bounds. Philadelphia will retain possession. And a moment now to look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it has been trending for Brogdon.
And one thing that has been very consistent for him the last few years, his ability to continue to deliver more and more offense. He's been doing everything that's been asked of him.
From deep, Richardson. That's in. He's 7 for 12 now in the game.
And so many teams now look to establish the perimeter to set up everything else.
No doubt it's a growing trend, Greg, and he is highly accurate tonight.
High arcing shot, and he sinks the layup. And now an 8-point 76ers lead.
Well, instead of forcing it all the way to the cup, he just goes with that little teardrop.
Chalk up two there. Right around 3 minutes into the second half. And here's Simmons. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. Richardson, no luck. The Pacers have gone 5-7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Drive in the pass to Warren. Over Simmons. And Warren the bucket on the assist from Brogdon. And now it's just a 4-point 76ers lead. 76ers have gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. It's Richardson on the wing. Richardson missing again.
You will not see this guy miss many of those. He's one of the keys to their floor spacing.
And Lamb slams it home.
You can see Turner evolving as a passer. He wants to set his teammates up. That's a pretty look.
Philadelphia's gone 2-5 with a 3-point shot since coming out of the break. Count that one. That's 12 points for Tobias Harris.
Well, it doesn't get much easier than that. Even a decent shooter is going to make that with no pressure.
Here's Brogdon. That one finds the mark. It's the 10th time he's done that tonight on 14 shots.
And now this game's taken on a whole new feel since halftime.
What energy we're seeing. Something has lit a fire under both of these teams.
Now here's Horford. 10 points for him. Ben Simmons gets the bucket.
Al Horford is such a tremendous passer as a big man. Wow, does he get work done offensively.
Turner finds Lamb. Back to Turner. Shoots over Embiid. Kept alive by Indiana. Here's Warren. Great look there, but off target.
You can't look at the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
And they should, because it's when you start turning down that kind of look that your offense can start to bog down a bit. What an aggressive mindset in this period. He's starting to take over.
Off the left rim and out.
Boy, what a job defensively. You couldn't play that any better.
And back in his day, as coach of the Blazers, players called Nate McMillan Sarge for his style. Very tough and demanding.
The beauty, though, Greg, to me is Nate McMillan has adapted. He has given more leeway for his players and his assistant coaches. He's willing to take players aside and bring a more personal approach. And I think in today's NBA, that's critical.
Jay McConnell, he's checked in for Malcolm Brogdon. And then for Philadelphia, Kyle O'Quinn, he's checked in for Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for Tobias Harris. And Raul Neto is subbed in for Ben Simmons. And the Pacers call time here. We've seen Josh Richardson really having a great game.
Well, I think this is a necessary timeout so they can figure out a way to limit the impact this guy's having from three-point range. They've got to dedicate more resources to their perimeter D.
Jake R. Sampson comes in for Domantas Sabonis. And Edmund Sumner's subbed in for Warren. That's good from Richardson. Pacers trail by 10. To stop the run. And it's good off the back rim and in. Samson's got his first bucket in this one. Philadelphia's gotten the three-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. Horford kicks to Neto. O'Quinn dishes to Horford. Pacers with the rebound.
Well, this is the kind of shot we've come to expect him to make. He's got to be upset with that one.
On the wing, Lamb. Kept alive, Turner. Gets it to go for bucket number 8. He's taken just 10 shots.
Well, Kevin, you love the determination, right? Miles Turner effectively getting to the window and getting another opportunity.
The pass to O'Quinn. And there's the defensive 3-second call.
Technical foul.
And historically, you almost never saw a great shot blocker who could also knock down triples at a high clip. But count Miles Turner among the unicorns who provide that rare combination.
And so he hits the technical free throw. And the stretch center in demand. For Miles Turner, Greg, how does he take that next step as a player?
Getting stronger. And continuing to improve his recognition and communication at both ends of the floor.
Doug McDermott, he's checked in for the Pacers.
Well, you like how aggressive he is making a play at the rim against Glenn.
You have got to believe that you can score against size on the interior. How about the aggressive, assertive move there?
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Here's Neto. Inside, here's Horford. The rebound by Turner. Turner's got his 7th rebound here tonight. Here's Sumner. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Sumner!
Now just a 5.76ers lead.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Here's Neto. He's covered by McConnell. Neto, the pass to Korkmaz. And it's off from 3-point range. Here's McDermott. Richardson cover. Nice shot by McDermott.
Simply no defense for that. McDermott is skilled at sinking tough shots.
The 76ers leading by 3. Neto kicks to Horford. At the top of the key, O'Quinn. And there's the call on Jakar Sampson. That is his first foul of the game. Mike Scott's checked in for Philadelphia. James Ennis comes in for Josh Richardson.
Ennis. Mike Scott.
Philadelphia with the ball. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pacers will take it.
Pacers ball.
Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Look at Philadelphia. Here in the middle of the regular season, they've been able to get the 4th best record in the conference. And, of course, the Indiana Pacers, a game behind.
Yeah, and seeing where the Pacers are, they've done a good job staying relevant this season. I was concerned they'd suffer a drop-off, but just give them credit. They've hung in here in this playoff race.
Now, resiliency has been crucial for this team. Anytime it looks like they may start to drag a little bit, they've picked it back up and stayed in the hunt.
Neto can't get it to go. And so it's Turner with it. He brings it up for the Pacers. They trail by 3.
See, I think it's critical that Miles Turner improve all facets of his game, especially how he distributes the basketball.
Philadelphia has gone 3-7 from 3-point range here in quarter number 3. Scott, the pass to Neto. Back to Scott. 6 to shoot. To stop the drought, and he hits the jumper for 2. Scott's got 9.
You know, you have to use the bounce pass in that instance to make the catch easier.
Yep, that one goes in there.
Easy, McConnell with the basket.
The 76ers shooting it beautifully here in the third, 56% from the field. Here's Korkmaz. He's got 6. Pass to Scott. And it's denied. And they'll keep possession. Down to 5 on the shot clock.
Second chance shot. Hits. How that one. Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over.
For viewers, timeout's a chance to check your phone, grab a drink, but for the teams, it's all about business.
Well, there's something that the coach doesn't like. I'm curious to see which kind of adjustment he makes here.
Not that boy, let it. I make everybody fall off. Handle life all black like a Batman. Dribble too much. Ooh, who is that man? Put your name and your labels on a hashtag. This too easy. It's like shooting on a trash can.
Watch you do but from winning, but I swear I had no conscience. Hit you with that yaya, drop you, pull up, and I pop it. Always hit the target, bro. This wrist got infrared. Ankle bully, book them doctors. Please come wrap his leg. It's breakfast and bed. Every day like what? These is on me tough. Let this thing go soon. I see daylight. Boom. Bottoms hot. Hey, check. Bottoms hot. Hey, check. Jazz, check. Jazz, check. Got him. Check.
Handle life all black like a Batman. Dribble too much. Ooh, who is that man? Put your name and your ankles on a hat.
Joel Embiid. He's checked in for Philadelphia. Break in the action means we can check out the best defensive teams in the league this season. Here are the real stats, real scores from the real NBA. Fourth, the 76ers.
This is a team that takes pride on the defensive side of the floor. I mean, they play hard and they play together. They are a tough group to score on. And let's review some numbers for Holiday. Averaging about 11 points. 3 assists and 2 rebounds. I mean, the numbers aren't bad on their own, but he knows that he can help this team in a bigger way.
And sometimes it comes down to the flow of the offense. One night it's your night, another night perhaps it's somebody else's.
First free throw is good. Good on both. Now Ennis, 12 points for him. Neto, the pass to Embiid. Count it, good. Embiid's got 5 points now this quarter.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
Well, the best players, to me, deliver night after night after night. So as long as he's hot, keep riding it.
And the Pacers can't get it to go. The 76ers leading by 3. Ennis kicks to Korkmaz. Back to Ennis. Passes it to Embiid. Offensive rebound. It's blocked. And so it looks like the 76ers will retain possession here. Pass to Ennis. Shot clock at 6. To the inside. And there's Embiid. That's good on the assist by Ennis. Ennis has got 3 assists now in this one. Here's Holiday. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact. And he'll go to the line for 2. These are his 3rd and 4th free throw attempts of the game.
Shooting for Indiana.
And you know, something I remember from their last game was how good he was at the
2
line.
Shots.
That free throw good from Holiday. Both free throws good from Holiday.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
1:52 left in the 3rd. And so it's Ennis bringing it up now for Philadelphia. Neto can't get it to go. They are right on the brink of taking the lead.
This is an absolutely critical juncture in this game.
76ers ball.
And a chance to check out Joel Embiid here. This last month, he's been positively spectacular. Sixth in rebounding, and he sits in the top 15 in points per game. An absolute powerhouse offensively.
And he's a top 10 rebounder this year for good reason. He's unbelievably driven, and he competes with you for the entire game. Now here's Ennis. 12 points for him. Off target from three-point range.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Unloads from 13. Here's Leaf. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Leaf's got 6.
You're fighting to keep the possession alive, something this guy does so well.
Here's Neto. The shot that time, not on target. And Indiana will come the other way.
This has not been a good period for this guy. Out of sync, not letting the game come to him. He's got to settle down and make shots.
As we approach the fourth quarter, still anyone's ballgame.
Yeah, neither team able to create much of a cushion.
Here's Neto. It's Korkmaz in the corner. And the officials call over the back. A little too aggressive there.
I'm not sure what he thought he could get away with there. Pretty clear over the back.
Yeah, easy call for the officials. Sometimes I think you can reach over without making contact, but that was not one of those times.
Well, free throw drops for Embiid. Some changes for Philadelphia. Tobias Harris has checked in for Korkmaz, and it's Ben Simmons in for Raul Neto. And Embiid drops them both.
Boy, a really soft touch on display. It is a luxury to have a big man who can hit from the line at a consistent rate.
It's good. Holiday's got 6 points in the quarter. 76ers trailing. 35 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. And here's Ennis. He's got 12. Taken away by Holiday. Here's Bitadze. Throws down the breakaway jam.
Gotta take care of the ball. They'll punish you if you're that careless.
That's right, and that's severe punishment right there.
Boy, in a tight game like this, that can change the whole tone. It helps your opponent get into a little bit of a rhythm.
Simmons against Holiday. A floater. Offensive rebound. Embiid can't get it to fall.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
We call that a great contest. You know this is something he brings to the table, the ability to anchor your defense.
And as we conclude the third quarter, what a game. Neither team giving ground. Pacers lead by 3. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
So we have some elite passing big men in the NBA, and you love that skill. Wow.
And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. And so in the game for the 76ers, we've got Harris. Mike's got out there with Embiid. And it's Ennis. And it's Simmons in at the one. first one falls for.
And a player who flew under the radar last year, Malcolm Brogdon. Pacers wanted to add him over the summer. Got a hefty deal from Indiana to leave the Bucks. Exactly the kind of player that the Pacers need.
He's perfect from the line this time.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Here's Embiid. It's good, the assist that time for Menace. And now it's 27 points for Joel Embiid. It's Brogdon on the wing. Guarded by Simmons.
Well, put all that size to good use. Rip it off the backboard.
And Harris, wide open, he shoots, and it goes out of bounds. That one off Harris.
Pacers ball.
Pacers leading by three. Brogdon right side, over Simmons, drops it in from 14 feet away. Brogdon's got 24 points.
From that in-between range, they've been the much better team.
The 76ers shooting has been fun to watch in this game. They're at 57%.
No doubt for me, the offense looks better. In the second half, they've been able to dial down those turnovers, and that's been a huge
Jeremy
help.
Lamb. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for the Pacers. Here's Brogdon. Here's Warren, banked in off the glass.
By TJ.
And the Pacers lead by seven.
Well, TJ Warren is terrific at using his frame to become a factor on the glass. I love it.
Simmons looking it over. Here's Scott. They get it again. And the dunk by Embiid.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this lead.
And Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spot. And that one's good, Brogdon.
You love how each side has risen to the challenge throughout this one.
I'll tell you, we have seen, Greg, great execution from both teams. Neither one giving an inch here.
There's the double team with Warren. The pass to Embiid. Now here's Ennis. Back to Embiid. Here's Simmons.
Oh! Wow!
And whenever Simmons gets a chance to show off his insane jumping skills, he's...
And Brogdon, here we go. Simmons with the defensive effort.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
And what you love about his work defensively, the ability to challenge and change shots without fouling.
And the Pacers with possession here. And so it's Lamb with it. He brings it up for Indiana. Leading by five. Brogdon fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Well, this is what you're trying to do. Put the game away.
And he hasn't forced much tonight, Greg. I love the efficiency he's giving to them.
And Indiana making a change here. Turner's checked in. Then for the 76ers, Horford comes in for Mike Scott. And it's Richardson in for James Ennis. That free throw good from Brogdon. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. The 76ers trail by eight. Richardson dishes to Harris. Simmons inside. He's guarded by Brogdon. No good from Simmons. And Warren the bucket on the assist by Turner. Warren's got the lead up to 10 now for the Pacers. The 76ers have gone 3 of 6 from the field so far in the fourth quarter. On the wing, Harris. The Pacers pull it in. Sabonis has got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. Here's Lamb. And again, it's Indiana converting.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
one thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. You lock in on the moment and play the right way.
Tipped away. It's stolen by Lamb. Jumps up. And Lamb slams it home.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury.
He rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish. And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. And they double up Simmons. Out to the wing. Here's Horford. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. 13 points for Horford.
Puts one in the eye of the defense. First triple of the evening.
Here's Lamb, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. That one on Richardson.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
Shooting for Indiana.
You feel like Jeremy Lamb has been in this league forever.
Taking two shots.
Mostly known for being a piece in the Harden trade when he left OKC, but Lamb is coming to his own the last few years.
Free throw drops for Lamb. And Jeremy Lamb, you feel like, Greg, he could be kind of a late bloomer.
The improvement he's shown the last few seasons has been huge. Much more comfortable as a scorer, and the defense has picked up for him as well.
And Lamb drops them both.
The way he's shooting free throws tonight, you simply don't want to put him there.
The 76ers trail by 13. No good from Simmons.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Here's Turner. Good for the basket. Number 9. He's only missed 2 shots from the floor all night.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
A good look from Embiid. The Pacers pull it in. Turner's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. And there's a whistle, and that's going to go on Simmons. And that'll be his 3rd foul so far.
And now only 1 away from being in the penalty.
Warren, the pass to Lamb. Trying his luck from deep. Good work defensively by Richardson. 76ers have gone 4 of 10 here in the final period. Not the time to go cold. And that one drops for him.
I love the spirit he's shown tonight, particularly on the offensive end.
And to me, he's just playing smart, efficient basketball, really helping his team hang around this one.
Brogdon! The 76ers trail by 16. Here's Simmons. Sabonis grabs the board. Sabonis has got rebound number 12 here already in the game. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. Lamb's got 14 points here in the second half. For Philadelphia, they've gone 5 of 12 from the field entering the fourth quarter. Simmons, good D by Brogdon.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
And slam dunk by Lamb.
Well, overall, they're the team getting the better looks here in this second half.
And I think what's happening is they're getting their shots within the flow of their offense, and you can clearly see the difference.
And it's Simmons penetrating. Lays it up off the glass. Simmons got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, offensively, this guy has been cooking. They're definitely not losing because of him.
They get it back. The shot by Turner, no good.
And his defense, so valuable. Not many can bother that shot at the rim.
Boy, you see the effort. You see the range. This guy prides himself in his ability to shut you down.
Timeout called, the Pacers.
And Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes, a timeout like this allows you to kind of just reset.
Morning. And Embiid has got the ball here for the Philadelphia 76ers. Here's Simmons, and Simmons slams it in.
I'm amazed at Simmons' athletic ability. He moves so fluidly for someone that size.
And it's Brogdon off the drive. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
That's his fourth personal foul.
Shooting for Indiana, Malcolm Brogdon.
Taking two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
And after attempting no free throws in the first half, now he's putting the defense back on its heels.
Brogdon hits them both. Richardson with it. To the middle. Here's Simmons. Well-timed pass, Ben, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Simmons got 12 points in just the second half. Brogdon against Richardson. The shot by Brogdon, no good. The 76ers trail by 16. Harris passes to Horford. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yep, that one goes. And 12 points for T.J. Warren.
You love that this guy doesn't get down on himself after a rough first half. Keep your composure and keep grinding.
Outside, Simmons. The 11-footer. That one wide left. Indiana leading by 18. Here's Lamb. That ball. Nice speed that time from Turner. Turner's got 5 assists in the game. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Outside, Simmons. And there's the 3-second call. This one on the defense. Teams, if they can keep the rights to their best player, we see it in other leagues. Could the franchise tag ever make its way, do you think, to the NBA?
Well, this is going to be a negotiation point between the Players Association and the league itself. And the reality is it's going to have to be negotiated. What we know unequivocally, Kevin, is that these players now in the player empowerment era have more control about what franchise they play for and how long the duration of their contract is. How this all shakes out remains to be seen, but it is a point of conversation amongst the 30 NBA teams and the league leadership. There's no question about it.
Embiid, the pass to Horford, and the dunk by Horford.
I love it when Al Horford is challenging defenders to stay with him. Use your physicality, big man.
Here's Sabonis. That's another one for him. It is fifth in just 7 shots.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
Here's Richardson. No good that time. Nice D from Sabonis.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today. And there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area. Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
And Lamb, here we go. And boy, that looked like goaltending. Yes, it is, and so they will award the basket there. Boris, all right, this is going to come out of the blue here, but if you had to choose between raising the height of the basket or widening the floor or even widening the lane, which would it be?
I have very strong feelings on this, Kevin, and for me it would be widening the floor. And the reason I say that is it feels to me in the last couple of years there are more sideline violations where teams are turning it over because they're trying to get to that corner three, one of the most advantageous, best shots in today's game. But because that three-point line is so close to the sideline out of bounds, we're seeing too many violations. So if I had to choose between one or the other, I would absolutely widen the floor. Well, two long-range bombs in the first, but that's stalled out right now.
Here's Brogdon, and there are the Pacers with another bucket.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
And Simmons has got the ball here for the 76ers. Pass to Horford. Back to Simmons. Embiid is at the elbow. Outside, Simmons. With some arc. The rebound by Turner. And here are the Pacers now. They're on a 14-6 run. Lamb against Simmons. And they double up Simmons. Feeds it to Embiid. And the dunk by Embiid.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
At the end of the day, though, it's 2 points. Don't hang your heads. Let's get refocused and play with more patience.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. Remember the time, Doris, when it was rare to see stars changing teams? Now we read about it every day.
No question, Kevin. Think back to my formative years watching the NBA as a fan. Larry Bird was a Boston Celtic. Magic Johnson was a Los Angeles Laker. The trend in today's NBA is that shorter player contracts, more player control over where they want to be. And the reality is this, Kevin, at some point, free agency entered the equation. It's appropriate, it's fair, they've earned the right to choose where they play.
And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Malcolm Brogdon.
And Kevin, it's a no-brainer. He's controlled every aspect of this game, and it's just so fun to see a player perform at a level that's just higher than anyone else out on the floor.
After two straight losses, they switched it up a bit tonight, giving him a much bigger role, and it's worked out even better than they could have hoped for. Pacers leading by 22.
2-1.
Holiday with it. Outguarded by Simmons. Holiday gets the bucket. Holiday's got 24. Philadelphia's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Richardson kicks to Simmons. And there's a minute 45 left in the fourth quarter. So far, we've seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Simply put, out of control is how they play thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline. You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Shakar Sampson taking two shots.
And he makes the first. Doris, when you look at draft eligibility requirements, it is a very fluid topic with a lot of different ways it could go, a lot of moving parts. Where do you stand?
I'll tell you the truth, Kevin. I'm conflicted about this because I believe there is real value to the college experience. There's high-level coaching across the game at the collegiate level. But I also believe that young men who have talent should be able to, when they are eligible, decide when they want to become professionals. So, listen, I'm sort of in the middle. There are legitimate arguments to be had for both sides. What I hope, regardless, is we get the best players in the league, and that's certainly going to happen whenever it happens.
And for the Pacers, they're shooting so well, the offensive execution has been brilliant. 66% from the field.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Pacers.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And so looking at their number, this will be win number 22 on the year.
And with this win now, we're all square, 1-1. Two more games yet to come in what's proving to be a very competitive season series.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Malcolm Brogdon.
No doubt he came to play tonight. This guy has been aggressive and effective.
Shooting for Indiana, Aaron Holiday. At the line for two.
Free throw, good, Holiday. Both shots good from the stripe. 54 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And it's Burke with the ball for Philadelphia. Knocked away. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here.
Philadelphia ball.
Right wing. Lets it go with a three. A shot by Milton. No good. Sumner passes to Holiday. And the layup's good off the glass.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
Yeah, playing with great energy and great effort. And as a coach, you'd love to see this from your team every single night.
To halt the run, Milton's shot is good.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
And guys, boy, when you're hitting, it sure does work. It obviously opens up major options at the offensive end.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. They're up by 29. 16 seconds left in the game. Guys, what do you think?
And they've got this one just about wrapped up.
It's not completely over, and they know that. But if they carry out their game plan, they should be golden.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter. And the basket is good. He's got a chance here for one more at the line.
That's his second personal foul.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
Well, for all intents and purposes, this game is over. Just a matter of time here.
One shot. One shot.
He banks in the layup.
Shake Milton.
8 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Holiday with the three, and the Pacers another three.
Aaron Holiday.
So no problem for Indiana as they get the win. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Olmstead, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.